Second game of the season for the Oxford baseball program. They opened the year with a 10-0 victory over the Troy Athens Redhawks on Tuesday. Today, it's the Oakland Christian Lancers. Should be a much tougher test, and we'll have every pitch for you right here on Oxford Community Television. 70 degrees here at Oxford High School, partly cloudy with some wind, but as Jim Price would say, it's absolutely beautiful. I'll try to read through the Oakland Christian lineup for you real quick as I battle the wind here. All right, Oakland Christian lineup. It'll be Chris Steffen, the pitcher, hitting leadoff. Jake Sewell, the second baseman, hitting second. Third, Jack LaCree, the shortstop. Hitting cleanup, first baseman Lucas Ford, left fielder Keith McAllister, fifth. Sixth, the catcher, Jaden Peterson. Seventh, the center fielder, Joe Shalalta. Eighth, the third baseman, Remington Spar. And ninth, the right fielder, Luke Douglas. First pitch from Benayash in there for a strike, and we're underway. Second pitch hit well in the air to center field. Carpenter back, that's gonna get over his head. It's gonna roll to the warning track, nearly to the wall. And Chris Steffen leads off this game with a double. There's a strike from Benayash, so 0-1. Man, I'm really battling the wind here with all my sheets blowing around quite a bit. Strike one is inside, 1-1. All right, second baseman Jack Sewell at the plate, 1-1 the count, right-handed hitter. Upright stance as the right hand's close to the right shoulder, his back shoulder. There's another pitch just inside, looked very similar to the 1-1, now it's 2-1. Chris Steffen, the pitcher, led this game off with a double. Nobody out, he's on second base. Jake Sewell, the second baseman at the plate. Popped up, foul territory, right field. And Brendan Campo, the right fielder, won't be able to get there. Foul ball, 2-2 the count. Campo is a right fielder, but he will not be hitting. The designated hitter, Joe Rohr, will hit in his place. So 2-2 on Jake Sewell. Looking for a strikeout or something on the ground here. Nice. Line drive to short, caught by Ethan Berdua, and that's going to be a double play. Ethan Berdua, nice alertness out there, grabbed it right before it hit the ground. Was able to step on second base behind Steffen. So one pitch and two outs for Eddie Benayash. Nice off-speed pitch for a strike in there to Jack LaCree, the shortstop. Ball up high, 1-1. Ball outside, 2-1 the count. Nolan Cucci, the senior, pitched a shutout on opening day for the Wildcats, and Eddie Benayash looking for a scoreless first inning right here. Late swing and a miss from LaCree, 2-2, and he's one strike away from it now. LaCree, right-handed hitter, number 37 on your television screen, right-handed stance. Takes a ball up high, runs a count full. Thank you. off pitch. Curveball and a beauty, apparently just missed low. Look like strike three from here, but that'll be a base on balls for Jack LaCree. Lucas Ford, the first baseman, number 33, a large young man, left-handed hitter. Extends the hands from the left shoulder. Benayash will throw over to Butsub at first, check on LaCree. Two outs, top of the first inning, scoreless game here at Oxford High School. Ball inside. 12 pitches for Benayash thus far, 7 of them strikes. Wind really whipping around here. Benayash will step off for a moment. Lucas Ford looks like he has some power in this bat. No, curveball misses outside there. Left fielder Keith McAllister on deck. There's a strike, 2-1. Outside, 3-1 the count. Jack Butsu holding LaCree here at first base. Gavin Walters putting down the signs for Benayash in the 3-1 on its way. Swinging a ground ball to Butsu at first. He'll step on the bag, and that's a scoreless top of the first. So Eddie Benayash allows a double and walks a batter, but no damage done. We'll head to the bottom of the first on Oxford Community Television. Bottom of the first inning here at Oxford High School. The Lancers of Oakland Christian did not score in the top half. And now the Wildcats, Brady Carpenter, center fielder, lead it off. Eddie Benayash, the pitcher, will hit second. Third is the second baseman, Tony Hatzigiorgio. Gavin Walters, the catcher, is the cleanup man. Brendan Moore hits fifth in left field. Joe Rohr, the designated hitter, hits sixth. Owen Schill, the third baseman, seventh. Ethan Berdua, the shortstop, eighth. And rounding it out is the first baseman, Jack Butsu. Butsu made the play in the final out of the top half of this inning. And Brady Carpenter to the plate. Carpenter swinging first pitch, grounds it 5-6 hole, and it's past the shortstop there, Jack LaCree. Looked like he might have been able to make a play on it. We'll score that a base hit for Carpenter, though. Don't know if LaCree ever quite got a glove on it, so that's a base hit for Brady Carpenter. Brings up the pitcher. Eddie Benayash, he throws left-handed but hits right-handed. Stefan will step off. Carpenter at first base has good speed. He is a threat to run. Stefan seems like he knows that. He'll throw over to Ford at first, keep him close. Ball low and outside. A Eddie Benayash was 1-for-2 in the season opener. Another throw over to first. No score, bottom of the first inning. Brady Carpenter with a single here to lead it off for the Wildcats. Strike from Stefan evens the count at 1-1. A little bit of an open stance for Benayash. Keeps that left foot showing bunt here, and he gets it down. That'll do his job. The pitcher, Stefan, fields it, throws to forward at first. Sacrifice bunt for Eddie Benayash, and Brady Carpenter moves up to second base. One out and a Wildcat in scoring position for Tony Hats of Georgia. Takes a strike on the outside corner. That was the fifth pitch of this game for Stefan. Hats of Georgia went 2-for-3 against Troy Athens. Two runs batted in that game. Cut on and missed here, 0-2. Something on the ground, right side here, should get Carpenter over to third base. Curveball fouled out of play, down the first baseline. Right now the wind pretty calm here at Oxford High School. Not bad at all when the wind's calm like this. Another 0-2 to Hats of Georgia. Outside, 1-2. Gavin Walters, the catcher, on deck. 1-2 the count on Tony Hats of Georgia. Swings there, hits a fly ball pretty deep left center field. That's carrying, and that's going to get down and bounce up against the base of the wall. Carpenter around third. He'll score easily. Tony Hats of Georgia, an RBI double, and the Wildcats out in front. 1-0 here in the bottom of the first. Third RBI of the young season already for Hats of Georgia. Man, off the bat, you would not have thought that was going to go all the way to the wall. Wind helped him out there, carried quite a bit. Now Gavin Walters, same scenario, Wildcat on second base with one out. Walters swings, fouls the first pitch out of play. Gavin Walters was 1-for-3 against Troy Athens, did have two runs batted in the game, though. Hit two RBI triple in that game. Takes a strike here, quickly behind 0-2. Nine strikes for Stefan. He's doing a good job in that department. Walters, right-handed hitter. Cut on miss, there's a strikeout. Second out of the inning. It'll be up to left fielder Brendan Moore now. Oxford up 1-0. Like to add on, get at least two here in the bottom of the first. Brendan Moore takes a ball high. Moore was 1-for-3 on Tuesday. Ahead here 2-0 now. High and tight, 3-0. Joe Rohr, the designated hitter on deck. Imagine Brendan Moore would be taking 3-0 here. He is, and it's a strike on the outside edge, 3-1. Stefan will step off, take a couple steps towards second base to walk heads to Giorgio back. 3-1, nice pitch in there for a strike. Count now full on Brendan Moore. Fouled off, and we'll do the 3-2 again. This next pitch will be number 19 for Stefan. Wildcats do a nice job making him work here. You can make the opposing pitcher throw 20 or more pitches per inning. You're doing a nice job. 3-2 pitch, off speed, got him looking. So two strikeouts in the inning for Stefan, but the Wildcats move in front, 1-0 here. And RBI double by Tony Hatzigiorgio. We'll go to the top of the second on your home for Oxford Wildcat Baseball, Oxford Community Television. Top of the second inning here at Oxford High School, 1-0 Wildcats. Tony Hatzigiorgio, the second baseman with an RBI double. It'll be Keith McAllister, Jaden Peterson, and Joe Shalalta to face the junior left-hander, Eddie Bianish. Ball up high to McAllister, right-handed hitter. There's a strike, nice pitch. Bianish allowed a double to begin the game and walked a batter in the first inning, but no one came around to score. Nice job of limiting any potential damage. Wind picking up here again at Oxford High School. On the inside edge, 1-2. Curveball grounded to third. In between hop off the arm of Owen Schill. So Keith McAllister on, we're gonna score that an error on the third baseman, Owen Schill. Bit of a tough play, but a play that should have been made. So for the second straight inning, the Lancers have the leadoff man on. It'll be the catcher, Jaden Peterson. Peterson waves and misses. Bianish will step off here, perhaps just giving the wind a moment to die down. Throw over to first, McAllister back in head first. One nothing Oxford, top of the second inning, quick throw over to first. Closer play this time, but McAllister back in there again. Third baseman Owen Schill playing on the grass here, perhaps expecting a bunt. Inside, 1-1 now the count on Peterson. Schill still about one step onto the infield grass here. Hatzigiorgio and Berdua double play depth. It is a bunt and it's fouled off. 1-2. .22 pitches, 14 strikes for Eddie Bianish. The count now 1-2 on Peterson. You'd expect the bunt is no longer in play here, but crazier things have happened. sun peeking through the clouds now. Curveball low, 2-2. Two hit foul down the right field line. We'll do it again. Oakland Christian, green jerseys with white lettering, white pants. Oxford, white jerseys, blue lettering, white pants. 2-2, Peterson just gets a piece of it at home plate. Fastball, Peterson able to spoil it down the first base line. Peterson putting together a nice at bat here. He'll see at least 8 pitches. And here is pitch number 8. Ground ball left side and through in the 5-6 hole, base hit. McAllister hold up at second base, so 2 Lancers on with nobody out here. Or no one out, excuse me. Keith McAllister reached on an error by Owen Schill, and then Jaden Peterson a single to left. They'll bring up Joe Shalalta, the center fielder. You would think this could be another possible bunt situation here. No bunt, Shalalta swinging away, first pitch, fouls it back, 0-1. Love to get something on the ground here. Ethan Berdua, Tony Hats, Giorgio, turn to double play. Nice curveball from Bianish, 0-2. Bianish way ahead in the count here. We'll see if he can get him to chase or what he throws him. And now with 2 strikes, there is a bunt, and it's a pretty good one. Bianish has a hard time picking it up. Shalalta safe, bases loaded, nobody out. All right, Remington Spahr, third baseman at the plate. Takes a strike at the knees. Corners of the infield playing in here. Top part of the strike zone, 0-2.
What's up, Tam?
The 0-2. Spahr stood there and took it. 3 pitch strikeout. That was much needed. Big out right there. All right, bottom of the order here, right fielder Luke Douglas. There's a ball high. Fouled out of play, 1-1. That was the 35th pitch for Eddie Bianish. spot with that strikeout of Remington Spar. Ground ball could get him out of this inning now. There's a ground ball. Hat to Giorgio. Mishandles it. Every Lancer will be safe. 1-1 the score now. As McAllister comes in to score, Peterson over to third. Shalalta down to second, and Luke Douglas now at first. We'll score that one in air on Tony Hat to Giorgio. Back to the top of the order, and Chris Steffen. Steffen doubled to begin this game. Hit it over the head of Brady Carpenter in center field. One out, bases loaded, 1-1 our score. We're in the top of the second inning. There's a ball high, 1-1 the count. Swing and a miss. Bianish ahead, 1-2.
Come on, Cats.
The only out in this inning thus far came via the strikeout. Love to have another one right here. Up high, 2-2. That was the 40th pitch now, so the pitch count beginning to be a little elevated here. Fouled out of play by Steffen. So it's been air, single, air, strikeout, air here for the Lancers in the top of the second. There's strike three. Bianish got Steffen looking. Second strikeout of this inning, second strikeout of the game. Now Jake Sewell lined into a double play to Ethan Berdua his first time up. Ball high. Sewell, number 42, right-handed hitter. Keeps the hands close to that right shoulder, swings. Hits one well at the left field. That's going to get down in front of Brendan Moore. It's going to score one run, make it two runs. And Douglas slides into third. Close play there, but he's safe. It's a two RBI single for Jake Sewell, and the Lancers now lead 3-1. Dave Herrick out to have a word with his junior left-hander. The entire infield will join the conversation here. 3-1, Oakland Christian leads Oxford in the top of the second. All three runs coming here in the top of the second. Once his mound visit concludes, it'll be Jack LaCree, the shortstop, at the plate. He drew a walk his first time on a pitch that looked like it could have been called strike three, but LaCree got the call. It was called ball four. So Jake Sewell with the biggest hit of this game at this early point. A two RBI single makes it 3-1. Strike at the knees. Strike one. Outside, 1-1. Next pitch will be number 47. Thirty strikes is a nice number. Throw over to first, pretty close play there. Sewell back in safely. Jack Butsu, the first baseman for the Wildcats. The 1-1, fouled out of play, 1-2. Gavin Walters, junior catcher, checking his wristband for the signs here. Puts him down for Benayish, but he'll step off. Now he's back on. 1-2 the count on Jack Legree. Ball outside, Walters wasn't able to handle it cleanly, and Sewell will take second base. So runners at second and third now with two outs, 2-2 the count. There's a strike. Got Legree looking. So Eddie Benayish ends up striking out the side here in the top of the second, but the Lancers score three times. They lead 3-1. We'll be back with the bottom of the second on Oxford Community Television. Bottom half of the second inning, Teddy Rockquist here for Oxford Community Television. 3-1, Oakland Christian leads Oxford. It'll be Joe Rohr, Owen Schill, and Ethan Berdua do up here. Joe Rohr had the game-ending hit on Tuesday, went 2-for-3, drove in 2 runs in that game. Chris Steffen back to work for his second inning. Shakes off Peterson, now he gets a sign he likes. Rohr swinging first pitch, pops it up, foul territory, first base side. Steffen, Peterson, and Ford all made some sort of an effort for it, and it dropped in between three of them. So Rohr will, new life here, behind in the count 0-1, but better than fouling out. Ball low, 1-1 the count. Chris Steffen threw 19 pitches in the first inning. Rohr swinging here. Hits one in the air, deep left center field, and it gets down. Got down in between McAllister and Joe Shalalt out there. It'll be a leadoff double for Joe Rohr. This Lancer outfield playing very deep, and it still got down out there. Nice piece of hitting there by Joe Rohr. Way to find a spot. So Owen Schill, he's looking for his first hit of the season. He was 0-for-2 on Tuesday. Schill takes a strike at the knees. The 0-1 in the dirt. Nice pick by Peterson to prevent that from going to the backstop. 1-1. On the outside corner, 1-2 on Owen Schill. 3-1, Oakland Christian leads here, bottom of the second inning on Oxford Community Television. Joe Rohr led off this inning with a double for the Wildcats. Ball low, 2-2. Swing and a miss, Shill down on strikes, one out, and now it'll be Ethan Berdua, the shortstop, at the plate. Roar still at second base. Third strikeout of the game for Chris Steffen. Berdua is 1-for-2 on Tuesday. Takes a ball low. Ethan Berdua, number 9, right-handed hitter, keeps the hands close to the chest. Bat cocked over the right shoulder. Takes a strike top of the zone, 1-1. His next pitch will be number 30 for Chris Steffen. Well high, 2-1. Jack Butsu in the on-deck circle. Swing and a miss by Berdua, 2-2 the count. Little check swing, ground ball right side. First baseman Ford couldn't handle it. A swinging bunt there for Ethan Berdua. First baseman Ford couldn't handle it, but based off how far he came off the bag to try to make that play, I don't know if they would have been able to get Berdua in time anyway. And Roar goes over to third base. So runners on the corners, one out. Jack Butsu at the plate. We will score that an error on the first baseman forward. So E3. Butsu swinging first pitch. Hits one foul down the left field line. From our vantage point here, we were blocked by the dugout, but it dropped, so it's just a strike. One, Oakland Christian leads. Wildcats have runners on the corners, just one out. Number 9 hitter Jack Butsu at the plate. He was 0-for-1 on Tuesday, did draw 2 walks though. Berdua took second base, kind of a half-hearted throw by Peterson down there, so now 2 Wildcats in scoring position. Roar on third base, Berdua on second base. 1-1 the count on Berdua. Takes a strike inside corner, 1-2. Wind beginning to pick up quite a bit here. Off the outside edge, 2-2. Nice eye there by Jack Butsu. High count now full, 3-2. Top of the order, Brady Carpenter on deck. Carpenter singled to begin this game. Ground ball, second base. Butsu out at first, but he does his job. Joe Rohr comes in to score. Now 3-2 game. RBI, Jack Butsu. First RBI of the season for Jack Butsu. Good for him. Brady Carpenter takes a ball high. This will be pitch number 40 for Chris Steffen. That is high for an inning and two thirds. Fouled out of play by Carpenter, 1-1. And on that Butsu RBI ground out, Berdua was able to move over to third base. In the dirt, 2-1, Peterson knocked it down, bounced a couple of feet away toward the left-handed batter's box, but not enough for Berdua to think about trying to come home. Carpenter swings, pops it up, foul territory. Lands just in front of the Oxford dugout, 1-2. Wildcats coached by Dave Herrick in his sixth season, would be his seventh season if 2020 wasn't canceled. He's at third base, Aaron Carpenter, Brady's father, in the first base coaching box. Two-two our count, 3-2 Oakland Christian our score. Bottom of the second inning, Brady Carpenter at the plate. He was hit by a pitch, and it looks like the umpire. All right, now they are giving him first base. It thought maybe the umpire was gonna say he didn't make an attempt to get out of the way, but hit by pitch, Brady Carpenter down to first base. Those of you that watch Major League Baseball saw a very controversial finish in the game yesterday, Thursday, between the New York Mets and Miami Marlins, where Michael Conforto leaned into a pitch that possibly would have been a strike. But they awarded him the first bit, hit by pitch, and the Mets won the game. Oakland Christian's coach was out here to discuss that one, but our home plate umpire, longtime veteran, told him that call is standing. Now they're gonna have a mound visit. Come talk to Chris Steffen. Lancer infield in there for this mound visit. It's beginning to dissipate here a bit now. Ford back to first. Sewell back to second. LaCree to third. Remington Svar. Back to third base. And Peterson back behind the plate. All right. Ready to get back to baseball here. Eddie Benayish at the plate. Runners on the corners for Oxford here. Berdua at third, Brady Carpenter at first. Two outs, Wildcats trailing by a run in the bottom of the second, 3-2. Benayish swinging first pitch. Carpenter was on the run and fouled it. Looked like he fouled it off that left foot, that front foot. Take a second to walk it off here. Dave Herrick over to talk to Eddie Benayish, home plate umpire talking to him. He's fine, gonna stay in there. Probably more of a stinger than anything. Just give it a few minutes and it should be okay. 0-1 the count. It was a foul ball. Carpenter had to go back to first base. We'll see if he runs again here. Steffen steps off. Thank you. Carpenter was on the move there, and the snap throw went down to third base. Ethan Berdua dove back in head first safely. So two Oxford base runners in scoring position. 1-1 the count. That was a ball to Benayash. Tony Hatz of Giorgio and Jack Butsu of the RBIs for Oxford. Oh, they're changing that. They're going to call that. But that was a strike now, apparently. 0-2. 0-2 the count, not 1-1. Now 1-2. That ball was high. That was the 46th pitch of this baseball game for Chris Steffen. In an inning and 2/3 of work thus far. 1-2, hit in the air, first base side. It'll stay in fair territory, and it'll be Steffen that makes the catch. So that'll end the second inning here, but the Wildcats score once, and they cut the deficit to 1 run. Oakland Christian leads 3-2 on Oxford Community Television.
Just think, what if we didn't have local TV and radio? Where would I go for local sports, local politics, a mayor, city council, stuff that affects me every day? How about health? Who's covering things that endanger my family? I need to know now, as it happens, from sources I trust, people in my community. No agenda, no bias like you find on cable and social media, just facts. For news I can trust, I stay local. Support your local station. Text TV to 52886 today.
Top of the third inning, Teddy Reich was with you all, Oxford Community Television. Oakland Christian leads the Wildcats 3-2. The junior left-hander, Eddie Benayash, back out there for his third inning of work. He will face Lucas Ford, Keith McAllister, and Jaden Peterson here, 4, 5, and 6 hitters for the Lancers. 49 pitches for Eddie Benayash thus far, 15 in the first inning, 34 in the second inning. All right, Lucas Ford. Big left-handed hitting first baseman. Takes a strike. Nice start here in the top of the third. Ball just low, 1-1. Benayash trying to paint that outside corner, missed with it, 2-1. Ford grounded out to Jack Butsu his first time. Curveball and a dandy, 2-2. Extends the hands away from that back shoulder. Takes strike three, inside corner. Four strikeout for Eddie Benayash. All four have been looking, and that's how the last four outs have been recorded. Keith McAllister swinging a miss here. Keith McAllister reached on an error by Owen Schill to lead off the second inning. Another swing and a miss, quickly 0-2. The strike two. Inside corner. Another strikeout looking. All five of Eddie Benayash's strikeouts are looking in this game. You do not see that often. And the last five outs he's recorded, all via the strikeout. Jaden Peterson, the catcher, up now. Peterson singled to left in the second inning. Fouls his first one out of play. Back behind home plate. Another foul ball, 0-2. This has been a really nice inning so far for Benayash. This will be pitch number 60 here, but again, he came into this inning with 49, so this will be a quick inning if he can finish it off. And he does. Strikes out the side for the second inning in a row. All six strikeouts looking. Only 11 pitches for Eddie Benaish in the top of the third. We go to the bottom of the third. Oakland Christian still leads by one, 3-2. Teddy Rackwest here for Oxford Community Television. Bottom half, the third inning, 3-2, Oakland Christian leads. Tony Hatzigiorgio, Gavin Walters, Brendan Moore, 3-4, and 5 hitters for Oxford. Hatzigiorgio had RBI double in the first inning. Hatzigiorgio off to a great start this year. He's 3-for-4 with 3 runs batted in this season. Swinging first pitch, foul ball. Looks like he fouled that one off his foot as well, like we saw Eddie Benaish do last inning. Dave Herrick telling him walk it off. That's Giorgio back in there. He's all right. The 0-1. Low, 1-1. This will be pitch number 50 for Chris Steffen. Popped up, foul territory. Lucas Ford, the first baseman, got a very late read on it. Falls 1-2 now the count. Sunshine now out, beautiful here at Oxford High School. Well high from Steffen, 2-2. Tony Hatzigiorgio, right-handed hitter, hits out of a bit of a crouch. Grounds out one foul. He'll skid past the first base coach, Aaron Carpenter, and he'll jog after it now. Hit on the ground, right side and through. Base hit, Tony Hatzigiorgio just continues to hit. 2-for-2 today, 4-for-5 this season. Gavin Walters, junior catcher at the plate now. He went down on strike swinging his first time back in the first inning. Throw over to first, Hatzigiorgio back in head first. Another throw over to first, and Hatzigiorgio probably would have been picked off that time, but Lucas Ford, the first baseman, dropped it. He was leaning, they had him, and Wildcats caught a break right there. Hatzigiorgio off, pitches a ball, throw down to second. He's in there safely, stolen base, Tony Hatzigiorgio. Jaden Peterson, the catcher, bounced that throw in there to Jake Sewell, the second baseman. If he got it there in the fly, they might have had him, but it's a stolen base. Hatzigiorgio at second base, no one out. Ball high to Walters, now 2-1. Excuse me, 2-0. Three and now nearly hit him up in the shoulder area that time. Walter's able to spin out of the way. This will be pitch number 55 for Steffen. 3-0, you'd imagine Walters is taken. even though he is a cleanup man for this Oxford team. He does take, and it's ball four. Four-pitch walk, Gavin Walters. So the first two Wildcats on here with Oxford trailing by a run. Gavin Marsden, the junior, number 7. He will courtesy run for Walters at first base. Brendan Moore at the plate. 2 on, no one out here. Bottom half of the third inning. Moore follows the first pitch back, 0-1. Remind our viewers and listeners the rule at the high school level, a courtesy runner. You can, what they call courtesy run for either your pitcher or your catcher. Those are the two positions. It's not the same as pinch running. The pitcher and catcher can still stay in the game. The 0-1, nice curveball from Stefan, 0-2. Another curveball fouled back. So Stefan has thrown more. Two straight curveballs here. We'll see if he tries to speed him up with the fastball. The strike two. Gets by Peterson to the backstop. Wild pitch. Each Wildcat moves up 90 feet. Hats to Giorgio now at third base. And Gavin Marsden, the courtesy runner, down to second base. Two Wildcats in scoring position. No one out here in the third inning. 1-2 the count on Brendan Moore, the left fielder. Now 2-2. Joe Rohr in the on-deck circle. A single would likely score two runs here. Moore asked for and is given time. Got a nice crowd on hand for this game today. I'd say there's more people here than there were for the Troy Athens game on Tuesday. Moore hits one well to left field. Left fielder Keith McAllister was there, made the catch, but it's a sacrifice fly, RBI for Brendan Moore. This game's now tied at 3 here in the bottom of the third. Nice job of situational hitting, Brendan Moore. So hats to Giorgio, tagged up and scored. Marsden stayed at second base there with the fly ball going to left field, which was almost more of a line drive than a fly ball. It was hit very hard, low to the ground off the bat of Moore, and McAllister hadn't played well out there, but a sacrifice fly ties this game at 3. Joe Rohr at the plate. The 1-0, fly ball, shallow center field. Catch was made by Joe Shalalta, the center fielder. Marsden gave him a little bluff like he was going to tag up, but he didn't. Stayed at second base. Now 2 outs, and it'll be up to Owen Chill. Chill grounds the first pitch foul. Chill struck out swinging in the second inning. This will be pitch number 64 for Chris Stefan. Through 2 2/3, that's high. Owen Schill, number 19, bat resting on the shoulder. Now he takes it off a bit. Takes a curveball for a strike, 0-2.
Hey, come on, one, man. You got this, Owen. You got this.
Ball well high, 1-2. Three-three here in the bottom of the third at Oxford High School. Schill, curveball to knee, strike three called. But the Wildcats score a run on the sacrifice fly by the senior left fielder, Brendan Moore. After three, we're tied at three on your home for Wildcat baseball, Oxford Community Television. Remington Spar, big third baseman. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Tried to lay a bunt down there and missed, 0-1. Throw over to first. Schlalta back in easily. 0-1 the count on Remington Spar. Spar wearing the pants up. One of the few Lancers to do it, but the entire Wildcat team does it. Another throw over to first. Real nice pitch there, 0-2. Quick throw over to first, it was a close play, but Schlalta back in there safely. Check swing, top of the strike zone, called strike three, eighth strikeout, Eddie Bianish. It'll be a strikeout looking, his seventh of that variety. It's number nine hitter, Luke Douglas. Top of the order, Chris Steffen in the on-deck circle. One out here in the top of the fourth inning. We're tied at three. Nice lead for Schlalta at first base. Pitch just low to Douglas. Douglas reached on an error by Tony Hatzigiorgio back in the second inning. Swing and a miss there, 1-1. Curveball in there, 1-2. One out, top of the fourth inning, 3-3. Another throw over to first, Schlalta back in there safely. Oxford took a 1-0 lead in the bottom of the first, then Oakland Christian went out in front 3-1. Now the last two to the Wildcats to tie this baseball game at three. The 1-2 to Douglas, ground ball is short, Ethan Berdua. Throw to second base, he bounced it in there. Nice pick by Tony Hatzigiorgio. So they get the out, Joe Schlalta at second base. Luke Douglas will be safe at first base, a fielder's choice. Now two outs here in the fourth inning. There's a strike to Chris Steffen. Steffen is doubled and went down looking in this game. Throw over to first base. They had Douglas leaning a bit. He initially leaned towards second, but then got back in safely. Douglas is off. Steffen swings. It's going to be a base hit to center field down in front of Brady Carpenter. Douglas will go to third. The hit and run works out there. Second hit of the game for Chris Steffen. Lancers on the corners here with two outs in the top of the fourth. Jake Sewell at the plate. First pitch is ball high. That was the 73rd pitch of the game. Check swing, ground ball to first base, stayed fair. Jack Bootsy will pick it up, step on the bag. So through 3.5, we're still tied at 3 on your home for Wildcat Baseball, Oxford Community Television. Bottom half of the fourth inning on Oxford Community Television. Wildcats and the Oakland Christian Lancers tied at 3. Ethan Berdua, Jack Butsu, Brady Carpenter, 8, 9, and 1 hitters to face Chris Steffen. Berdua reached on an error by the first baseman. Lucas Ford back in the second inning. Senior shortstop. Takes the ball high. Now ball outside, 2-0. Steffen's thrown 68 pitches already. His pitch count is very high for this point in this game. You would think even if this fourth inning goes well for him, he'll end it around 80. There's a strike to Berdua, 2-1. Berdua showing bunt, gets it down. Pretty good bunt. Steffen fields it, barehanded, throws to Ford, got him. Nice play, Chris Steffen, the pitcher. Jack Bootsu grounded out the second, but did pick up an RBI back in the second inning. Left-handed hitter. Strike on the inner edge. Swinging there, line drive to second base. Jake Sewell hadn't played well. Two down here in the bottom of the fourth. Number 8, Carpenter. Brady Carpenter, he's singled and been hit by a pitch in this game, been on base twice. Fouls the first one to Dave Herrick. Ball off the plate outside, 1-1. This will be pitch 75 for Stefan. And it's a strike. It was an off-speed pitch of some variety. Couldn't quite tell if that was a curveball or changeup, but nonetheless, 1-2 on Brady Carpenter now. Bottom of the fourth inning, 3-3 our score. High fastball fouled out of play. Hitting the air, shallow left center field. Keith McAllister, left fielder, made a sliding attempt at it, didn't make the catch. That'll be a single for Brady Carpenter, his second hit of the day. And the Wildcats avoid going down in order here. They have not had a, Chris Steffen has not had a 1-2-3 inning all day. He's faced at least five Wildcats in every inning. Eddie Bienes, strike on the inside corner, looked like a ball from my vantage point, but called a strike. There's another strike, 0-2. This will be number 80 for Stefan. I said at the beginning of this frame he would likely finish it around 80, even if it went well. And here will be number 80. Brady Carpenter on first. We'll see if they let him run here. He is running. Pitch is outside. Carpenter's in there. Stolen base, Brady Carpenter. So now a base hit by Eddie Benash would very likely give the Wildcats the lead here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Pitch is inside. Outfield shifting Bienish to pull here, fouls it back. Very extreme shift in the outfield here. The right fielder is to the left of the word baseball on the wall. Much closer to center field than right field. Curveball strikes out Bienish looking. So Brady Carpenter stranded after four on Oxford Community Television. Wildcats and Lancers still tied at three. We have a good one for you.
Do you love local sports? Whether it's Oxford High School or Parks and Rec, you can buy copies of each game. To purchase your copy, call us at 248-628-9658 or give us an email at manager@occtv.org or talk to us at the next game. Hopefully we'll see you there.
Top of the fifth inning at Oxford High School. Wildcats and the Oakland Cushion Lancers still tied at three. Our first pitching change of the day, Logan Marshall, number 24, sophomore right-hander in. So Eddie Bianish's day is done. He pitched well, though. Allowed three runs in his four innings, had eight strikeouts. Marshall's first pitch of the day is a strike to Jack LaCree, the shortstop. The 0-1 flared in the air, right field base hit, got past Tony Hatzigiorgio in front of Brandon Campo. So leadoff single for Jack LaCree. You got Lucas Ford, first baseman now at the plate, takes a ball low from Logan Marshall. Home plate umpire calling Marshall in to talk to him about something. Home plate umpire saying the white, the color white on Marshall's glove is borderline, was his word for a pitcher, because they can, there's a strike from Marshall, but yeah, the rules are very strict on pitchers wearing the color white to prevent them from hiding the baseball. It makes it tough for the hitter to pick it up, but they're gonna let Marshall continue. It's not really a problem. 1-1 on Ford, and then Marshall pickoff throw over to first was in the dirt. Nice pick by Jack Bootsy there to prevent Legree from advancing at least one base. Fouled by Ford, 1-2. Three-three our score. We're in the top of the fifth inning. No outs, Jack Legree on first base. Lucas Ford at the plate, takes a ball. 2-2 now the count. Ford is grounded out to Jack Bootsu and struck out looking in this game. Pitch in the dirt, count now full. Payoff pitch to Lucas Ford from Logan Marshall. Low, he walked him. So the first two Lancers on here in the top of the fifth. Keith McAllister, left fielder at the plate now. Swing and a miss by McAllister. There's a strike in the outside edge, 0-2. Nice pitch by Logan Marshall. McAllister 0-2 today. He's reached on an error and struck out Logan. Another one of those strikeouts sounds nice right here. Jack Legree was in motion there, and he had third base stolen had it not been fouled by McAllister. Teddy Rock was with you for Oxford Community Television. Top of the fifth, 3-3, 0-2 the count on Keith McAllister. Throw to second base, keep an eye on Legree. Logan Marshall on the mound for your Wildcats. His first inning of work. Eddie Bianish went the first four. Marshall only a sophomore. Ball high to McAllister. One, two, top of the zone, struck him out looking. First strikeout of the season, Logan Marshall. One out here in the top of the fifth. Lance are still on first and second base. Bring up the catcher, Jaden Peterson, takes the ball outside. Walters throw down to first. Ford back in there safely. Yeah. Temperatures dropped a bit here at Oxford High School, turning into a bit of a chilly late afternoon. Ball high, 2-0. This will be Logan Marshall's 15th pitch. Swinging a miss, LaCree going down to third. Throw gets past Owen Schill. Picked up by Brendan Moore. But LaCree will come around to score. 4-3 Oakland Christian. All right, 4-3 Lancers now in the lead. How I would score that is a stolen base for Jack LaCree, and then he scored on an error by Gavin Walters. That throw was in the dirt. I can't put that on Owen Schill. Peterson fly ball center field now. Brady Carpenter makes the catch. So two down, Lucas Ford on second base. Number 7 hitter, Joe Schlalta, Lancer center fielder. Takes a ball outside. Four-three Oakland Christian leads here in the top of the fifth. Logan Marshall just misses 2-0. Schlalta upright stance, the 2-0. There it is, 2-1. Schlalta 0-for-2. He's reached on an error and struck out in this game. There's a ground ball left side. Ethan Berdua charges, bobbles, but recovers. Throw to first in time for the out. So Lancers score one run. Logan Marshall did a nice job in preventing any further damage. So after 4.5, Oakland Christian leads your Wildcats 4-3 on Oxford Community Television. Bottom half of the fifth inning on Oxford Community Television. Teddy Rogquist with you. Wildcats trail the Oakland Christian Lancers 4-3. Wildcats were down 3-1 earlier in this game and came back to tie it at 3. And then Oakland Christian moved back ahead by 1 here in the top of the 5th. Tony Hatzigiorgio, Gavin Walters, Brendan Moore. 3-4-5 hitters to face Chris Steffen, who's in his 5th inning of work. He's pitched this entire game for the Lancers. Heads to Georgia, swinging first pitch, ground ball, second base. Jake Sewell to his left, flips to Lucas Ford. One pitch, one out for Steffen here in the bottom of the 5th. First time the Lancers been able to retire Tony Heads to Georgia today. He was 2-for-2 before that. First pitch of Gavin Walters, off-speed pitch that gets by Jane Peterson all the way to the backstop. Brendan Moore will go pick it up. Two and oh on Walters. Walters strikeout swinging and a base on balls today. So all for one. Now ahead here in the count, 3-0. think Stefan is in his last couple of hitters here. This will be pitch number 88. It's a strike, 3-1. And there's ball four. Gets by Jane Peterson. And Walters is gonna go all the way to second on it. Oh, they're gonna call him out. Walters beat the throw there, but looked like he momentarily came off the bag. Jake Sewell, the second baseman, alertly applied the tag, and our field umpire called him out. So now two outs here. It was a good idea by Gavin Walters, and he did beat the throw there, but just momentarily came off the bag. Brendan Moore takes the ball, 1-0. Two outs here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Oakland Christian leads 4-3. Foul ball there. Brendan Moore just got a piece of that off-speed pitch from Stefan, who has now thrown 91 pitches in this game. So you would think this is his last inning. Joe Rohr on deck. 2-1 on Brendan Moore, and Stefan's command seems like it's starting to leave him. Brendan Moore into right field, base hit. He's gonna try to stretch it for a double, and he's gonna be in there. Had that outfield shift we were talking about last inning. Right fielder playing well over in right center field. And what would normally just be a single turns into a double for Brendan Moore. Oakland Christian coach coming out, and you would think this might be the end of the day for Stefan. Hasn't taken the baseball yet from him. He's just talking to him. Might leave him in. At, by my count, 93 pitches. Yeah, he's Oakland Christian coach, gonna leave Chris Stefan in there, let him try to finish this fifth inning. Fifth inning where the Lancers lead 4-3. In Major League Baseball, the starting pitcher needs to complete at least five innings to qualify for the win. That's not the case at the high school level. High school level, it's only four innings in a seven inning game. Joe Rohr at the plate, Brendan Moore at second base. First pitch to Rohr, high strike. Curveball strike, 0-2. That was a nice curveball from Chris Stefan. Rohr is doubled and flat out to center. The 0-2. Gets by Peterson, Brendan Moore down to third base. And we've seen three or four pitches from Chris Stefan here in this fifth inning go to the backstop already, and another one would score Brendan Moore and tie this game. Yeah! Hit on the ground by Rohr, under the glove of the shortstop LeCree, 4-4. Tie game as Brendan Moore comes in to score. Joe Rohr, we'll give Rohr a single for that. RBI single, Joe Rohr. We're tied at four here in the bottom of the fifth. And now that is going to be it for Chris Stefan. 4-4 here in the bottom of the fifth inning on Oxford Community Television. It was Joe Rohrer's RBI single scoring Brendan Moore that tied us here. And before that, Brendan Moore had an RBI in the third inning on a sacrifice fly. In the second inning, Jack Butsu had an RBI and a ground out. And in the first inning, Tony Hatzigiorgio had an RBI double. The new pitcher here for the Lancers is number 37, Jack LaCree. Started this game at shortstop. And that's where Stefan's going to go. So Stefan's going to stay in the game, play shortstop. LaCree's going to move from shortstop to the mound. And the first batter he will face is Owen Schill. So both managers now into their bullpen a bit. Second pitcher of the game for the Lancers, and the Wildcats have used two thus far. We'll see if Logan Marshall goes out there again for the top of the sixth inning. Owen Schill turning around in left-handed here. He's batted right-handed this season until this point. Swings, fouls, first pitch off his foot. So good for Owen Schill. Not a lot of high school sophomores that can switch hit. And that was hit well, but fouled down the right field line, 0-2. And it's only been two pitches, but I think I like Schill's swing better from the left side than what I've seen from the right thus far. And with most of the pitchers you face at the high school level being right-handed pitchers, it makes a lot of sense to hit left-handed. Nice. Schill hit by the pitch. So Jack LaCree comes in, hits the first batter he faces, Owen Schill. Joe Rohrer down to second base, and it's up to Ethan Berdua to keep this fifth inning alive now. Berdua fouls first pitch out of play. Berdua 0-2 today. Sounds like a great time for his first hit, which would possibly score Joe Rohrer, depending, of course, on where it's hit. Jack Butsu on deck. 4-4, Oxford and Oakland Christian, bottom of the fifth inning on Oxford Community Television. Pitch was outside. Joe Rohrer advanced to third base as it scooted away from Peterson. Peterson made a good throw down there to Remington Spar, but Joe Rohrer was able to slide in safely. Owen Schill stayed at first base, however, so runners on the corners now. Ethan Berdua at the plate, the 1-1. Low, 2-1. Berdua line to left field, base hit. Joe Rohrer's gonna come in to score. Owen Schill holds up at second base, and the Wildcats have their second lead of the game now, 5-4. Ethan Berdua, RBI single. First lead for the Wildcats since it was 1-0 in the bottom of the first.
Hey,
Jack Butsu swinging first pitch, ground ball. Jake Sewell at second base. He'll flip to Chris Steffen, the new shortstop. They'll get the out on Berdua there. But the Wildcats move back in front, 5-4 after five on an RBI single by the senior shortstop, Ethan Berdua. We'll be back with the sixth on Oxford Community Television. Teddy Rock was for Oxford Community Television, top of the sixth. The Wildcats lead the Oakland Christian Lancers 5-4. Logan Marshall, the sophomore, back out there for his second inning, facing Remington Spar, swing and a miss. Wildcats move back in front, 5-4 in the bottom of that fifth inning on an Ethan Berdua RBI single. 0-2 now on Spar. Oh, 2 in the dirt, blocked by Gavin Walters. Another one in the dirt, 2-2. Logan Marshall on the mound, Gavin Walters behind the plate, Jack Butsu at first, Tony Hatzigiorgio at second. 2-2, Spar just got a piece of it in and out of the glove of Walters. If Walters would have been able to hold on to that, it would have been a strikeout. Owen Schill at third base, Ethan Berdua at shortstop. 2-2, hit back up the middle, Berdua gets to it, nice play behind the bag. Ends up well on the second base side, second base. Oh, wow, they're gonna call Spar safe at first base. They're saying Jack Bootsy must have pulled his foot off the bag. Dave Herrick was out to have a mound with the home plate umpire. Home plate umpire, I think, is telling him, you need to go talk to my partner. That was his call. And I'm sitting here doing this game for OCTV almost directly down the first baseline. It didn't seem like Jack Butsu pulled his foot. It looked like an out to me. And now these two umpires are going to confer and discuss here. And now they're going to call him out.
There's the right call. All right, I'm
you don't see that very often. Umpire changes call. Now the first base coach, Oakland Christian, is going to have a word with this umpire in the field. Spar is still standing on first base. He has not gone back to the dugout. Oakland Christian head coach, who's the third base coach, he's not happy. I don't blame him. But I think they ultimately did get that call correct. It looked like Spar was out, initially called him safe, then they discussed, thought better of it, called him out. One out here in the top of the sixth. Now Luke Douglas swinging, foul ball. Caught by Gavin Walters, almost a collision with Jack Butsu, but now two outs here in the top of the sixth. So we'll be back to the top of the Lancer order, Chris Steffen. ball outside to Stefan. Logan Marshall looking for a 1-2-3 inning here. 2-0, that one was just high. Strike at the top of the zone, 2-1. Hit well, but foul down the right field line by Stefan. Campo made a run after it, but it was out of his reach. 2-2 the count. This will be the 30th pitch for Logan Marshall. In the dirt, check swing, not even getting an appeal down to the first base there. Stefan did not go, full count. There it is, strikeout 1-2-3 inning for Logan Marshall. After 5.5, Oxford leads Oakland Christian 5-4 on your home for Wildcat Baseball, Oxford Community Television. Bottom of the sixth inning at Oxford High School, 5-4. Wildcats in the lead over Oakland Christian. New pitcher for the Lancers will be a left-hander, Lucas Ford. And he'll have to deal with the top of the Oxford order, Brady Carpenter, Logan Marshall, and Tony Hatzigiorgio. First pitch from Ford gets by the new catcher, who is Jake Sewell, and goes to the backstop. Jake Sewell played the first 5 innings at second base, now behind the plate. A called strike, an interesting windup here from Lucas Ford. He's got a noticeable hitch in the delivery. Very over the top, 2-1. Over the top delivery, that is. Two on one, and Carpenter leading off the bottom of the sixth, 5-4 Wildcats in the lead on Oxford Community Television, swinging a foul ball, 2-2. Logan Marshall, the sophomore pitcher, he's on deck. It will be his first plate appearance of the day. Count now full on Carpenter, high and outside.
All right.
Hit well by Carpenter to right field, and with that extreme shift, that'll get down. Carpenter around first, stand up double here to lead off the bottom of the sixth, Brady Carpenter. All right, leadoff double here for Brady Carpenter at the bottom of the sixth inning. Logan Marshall at the plate for the first time today. First time this season. And he takes a ball from Lucas Ford. Ford, number 33 on your screen, left-hander.
Good eye, good eye.
Now 2-0. Popped up by Marshall, foul territory down the right field line. Second baseman, who is Chris Steffen, now made a run after it. Couldn't quite get there, 2-1. So Chris Steffen's at second base, and Jack Legree is back at shortstop. Steffen's played all over. He's started this game as a pitcher, then briefly played shortstop, now at second base. And the new first baseman is Jaden Peterson, who caught the first five innings. I believe that is all the changes for you, for the Lancers. Swing and a miss by Marshall, 2-2.
You're good, 2-4, you're good.
No outs here, bottom of the sixth inning, Brady Carpenter on second base. Logan Marshall at the plate. The 2-2 from Lucas Ford, he'll step off. Now the 2-2 from Ford. Fouled right at home plate, so Marshall will see another one. On the outside corner, called strike three. First strikeout for Lucas Ford. Logan Marshall down, looking to bring up Tony Hatzigiorgio. Hatzigiorgio grounded out to second base his last time up to lead off the bottom of the fifth. 2-for-3 today. Carpenter off for third, and he's going to be in there. Pitch was in the dirt. Brady Carpenter, nice piece of base running, took third base. 1-0 on Hatzigiorgio. Love to add at least one run of insurance here if you're the Wildcats. And with Carpenter on third base and only one out, a golden opportunity. Upstairs, 2-0. on the outside corner, 2-1. Ford working from the stretch, the 2-1. Well outside, 3-1. Gavin Walters on deck. High and outside, walked him. Base on balls for Tony Hatz of Giorgio. Ball low to Gavin Walters. Lucas Ford having some issues finding the strike zone here, struggling with his command. Hatz of Giorgio off. Pitches ball too high. Hatz of Giorgio will move into second base without a throw. Two Wildcats in scoring position, just one out. 5-4 Oxford leads, bottom of the sixth inning. Two out to Walters. Called strike, 2-1. Bottom part of the zone there, looked like it could have been called ball three. Home plate umpire gave it to Ford though, 2-1 the count. Now it's 3-1. Brendan Moore on deck. Strike in the inside corner, count full on Gavin Walters. Brady Carpenter on third base. Tony Hatz of Giorgio on second base. Single here from Walters would likely score both of them. Outside, second straight walk. Base is loaded with just one out now. Of a courtesy runner for Walters, and we'll have a mound visit here for the Lancers. A courtesy runner will be Joshua Brown, the senior, number 31. All right, Oakland Christian mound visit wrapping up. Lucas Ford staying in there. Bases loaded with just one out here in the bottom of the sixth. Oxford leads 5-4. Very nice chance to add to that right here with Brendan Moore at the plate. Carpenter on third, Hatz of Giorgio on second, and the courtesy runner, Joshua Brown on first. Brown running for Gavin Walters. Moore swinging first pitch, fly ball right field, that's gonna get down. Carpenter scores, Hatz of Giorgio coming, he's gonna score two. Brown over to third, two RBI single for Brendan Moore, 7-4 Wildcats here at the bottom of the sixth. What a big hit, Brendan Moore. Three RBI day for Brendan Moore. How about that? Joe Rohr at the plate.
He's got 33.
Tried to check his swing, called a strike. Now there's a strike on the inside corner, 0-2 on Rohr. Brown on third base, Moore on first. 7-4 Oxford, bottom of the sixth inning on Oxford Community Television. Good take, Joe Rohr, 1-2. Ford's 1-2 outside. Snap throw down to third base. It hit Brown in the back, skids into left field. Brown will come in to score. And Brendan Moore, who was off on the pitch, goes all the way from first to third, now 8-4 Oxford. The 2-2 to Joe Rohr, swing and a miss. That's the second out of the inning.
Hey, come on, 1-9.
With Brendan Moore on third base, Wildcats leading 8-4. Some faint raindrops beginning to fall here. Owen Schill at the plate, back to hitting right-handed against a left-handed forward. Schill will swing first pitch. Fly ball right field, drops in front. Brendan Moore comes in to score, 9-4 Wildcats. Ethan Berdue on Oxford now with a 5-run lead here in the bottom of the sixth, 9-4. Pitch in the dirt, knocked down by Sewell, throw down to second. Schill's in there safely. Berdue, a shot left center field gap, gonna get all the way to the warning track. Schill around, he'll score, RBI double. Ethan Berdue, 10-4 Oxford here. Wildcats now batted around here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Boots, who's the ninth man to the plate. I was gonna say, Ford was pitching from the windup there. I don't know why Berdue didn't take third base. Maybe it's just because of a 6-run lead, but easily could have. Yeah, now Ford's in the stretch. Jack Boots at the plate. Popped up by Butsu. Catch is made by the first baseman, Jaden Peterson, and that'll wrap up the sixth inning. So we'll go to the top of the seventh. Oxford ahead by 6 runs and needs just 3 outs to put the finishing touches on this one and move to 2-0 on Oxford Community Television. Top of the 7th, Oxford leads Oakland Christian 10-4. Wildcats scored 5 times in the bottom of the 6th. New pitcher, Tony Hatz of Georgia. Hatz of Georgia, the junior. He had been playing second base for the first 6 innings of this game. New second baseman will be the senior Nolan Cucci. Jake Sewell swinging first pitch, pops it up on the infield. Owen Schill tosses the hat aside, makes the catch. One out here in the top of the 7th, and the Wildcats 2 outs away from a 2-0 start. Jack Legree, the shortstop, he swings first pitch, foul ball. Nearly caught by the first baseman, Jack Butsu, but it'll just be strike one. Wildcats scored 10 runs on Tuesday in the shutout of Troy Athens, now 10 here today. It's a pretty nice average if that holds up. There's a strike from Hatz of Georgia, 0-2. He's thrown 3 pitches, 3 strikes. Just low to Jack Legree. Rain beginning to fall more heavily here at Oxford High School, the 1-2. Off the end of the bat, caught by new second baseman Nolan Cucci. 2 down, 1 more out to go, and it'll be Lucas Ford, the left-handed hitter who began this game at first base and then pitched the top half of this inning. Did not fare well as the Wildcats scored 5 runs off him. And he's the last hope here for the Lancers in the top of the 7th. Low and outside from Hatz of Georgia. There's a strike at the knees, 1-1. Fouled right into the screen in front of us here, 1-2. Wildcats, 1 strike away now. That's a Giorgio delivers, the 1-2. Foul ball out of play, and we'll do it again. Very interesting weather day here. We've had, it's raining, but now the sun's out. It's been cloudy for long stretches of this game and really windy when we first started. We've just about seen it all here. 1-2 on Lucas Ford, here it is. Low, 2-2. called strike three on the, we'll call it the high and outside corner, and that'll do it. The Wildcats improved to 2-0 in 2021 by defeating the Oakland Christian Lancers here at Oxford High School 10-4. For Oxford Community Television, I'm Teddy Rodquist.